The Amazon WorkSpaces family of products provides customers with multiple options to deploy managed virtual desktops to end users. WorkSpaces Pools is our non-persistent desktop option, and it requires SAML for user authentication. This video is part one of two demonstrating end-to-end setup of WorkSpaces Pools with Okta. In this video, we will create a WorkSpaces Pools setup and begin the Okta implementation for authentication. In a second video, we will finalize the setup. You will need an existing Okta setup to follow along with this video. My name is Dan Garibay, and I'm a senior worldwide specialist solution architect. I work with our end user compute portfolio of Amazon WorkSpaces and Amazon AppStream 2.0. Let's get started. First, we will begin by creating a WorkSpaces pool setup, which means a WorkSpaces pool directory and the WorkSpaces pool itself. Next, we will create the SAML authentication application in Okta, perform the majority of the Okta-specific steps, and configure the SAML sign-in settings on the WorkSpaces pools directory. Let's get started. To begin, open the Amazon WorkSpaces console. In this view, I'm in the US West 2 region for this demonstration. Select Directories in the left column. Then select Create Directory on the right side. Select the Pool option and scroll down. Under the User Access URL field, we're going to put a placeholder value for now, as we don't yet have the URL. Skip the next field. In the directory name field, do not enter a fully qualified domain name as you might with an AD connector directory. Instead, enter a friendly name. For networking and security, I'm going to uncheck this box. This box gives the instances public IPv4 addresses, which I don't need in order for them to get to the internet because they're going into subnets that have NAT gateways. After selecting your VPC subnets and security group, scroll down more. I'm going to skip the Enable Dedicated Workspace configuration box. That is something you would check if you were going to use Bring Your Own License Windows 10 or 11 desktop workspaces. I'm going to stay with the license included Windows Server-based workspaces for this demo. I'm also going to scroll past the Active Directory config section, and we will be setting up a directory that does not use Active Directory here. For the streaming properties, I will leave these as the defaults. If you wanted to do things such as control whether or not users are allowed to print, whether or not users are allowed to use the clipboard, whether they have home folders, this is the section where you would control that. Similarly, if you would like to attach an IAM role to the fleet instances for the WorkSpaces pool, this is where you would attach that as well. Finally, I will choose the Create Directory button. Now that the directory has been created, I'm going to select the directory from the list so we can see the details page. Now that the directory has been created, we can create the pool. Middle select the pools option in the left column so that this opens in a new tab. We'll need to continue to go back to the directories tab throughout the future steps, so it's best to keep it open. Now we'll choose the Create Workspace button. In this field, select I know what workspace options I need for my use case, and then select Next. Select Pools under Workspace Type. And provide a name and description. I'm going to use a public bundle here. And I'll use a power based on server 2022 bundle. I'll bump the disconnect time and idle disconnect time up from the defaults. But I'll otherwise leave the settings as their defaults. Then I'll select Next and select the directory that I just created. Then I'll select the Create Workspace Pool option. Lastly, I'll select the pool that we just created and select Start. The pool will take a few minutes to start, which will give us plenty of time to complete the rest of the steps. With the Workspaces Pool directory and the Workspaces Pool itself having been created, we can now proceed to the next step, which is creating the Okta integration and doing the initial configuration of it. To begin, we'll need the registration code from the directory details page. Select the icon next to the registration code to copy it. In a text editor, we'll need to construct the relay URL that will be used in the Okta setup. This, along with other items which will need to be copied and pasted, will be provided in documentation links in the description of this video. Paste the registration code that you just copied from the console at the end of this URL here. And then replace the region here with the region that you are building the Workspaces Pools directory setup in, which for my purposes here is US West 2. Then copy this and we'll use it in this next step here in the Okta admin console in the application section. Select the Create App Integration button, and then select SAML 2.0 and the Next button. Provide a name here. Then select Next. Paste the value that we just constructed in the default relay state field here. And then for single sign-in URL, paste the value here, and for audience URI, paste this value here. Leave the box here checked, and switch the name ID format to persistent. Leave the application username and update application username fields at their default. Then, in the attribute statement section, there will be a few attribute statements to add, the first of which ends in the principal tag email. Switch its name format to unspecified and the value to user.email. Then we will provide the name ending in role session name. Switch the name format to URI reference and username with a capital N. And we'll add one more for the session duration. Switch this to basic and supply a value of 3600. This is a value in seconds and it can be customized based on your needs. But this is a good starting point. Scroll down, select Next. Check the box that says this is an internal app we have created, and select Finish. Expand the More Details section and copy the sign-on URL by selecting this button. Then return to the directory's console, select the Edit button button in the authentication section, and then select the Edit SAML 2.0 Identity Provider button, and replace the placeholder value with the value that was just copied. Now select Save, and you can return back to the main directory details page. Leave this tab open. We'll need it in subsequent steps. Thank you for watching part one of our video guide demonstrating end-to-end setup of Amazon Workspaces pools with Okta. I hope that you found this helpful. Please look forward to part two, where we will complete the setup. There are reference links in the description of this video to help with the steps where you need to copy and paste. And be sure to check out our other videos for more AWS end-user computing content.